have one, or sometimes it's been separate from each other, right. But it's not often that they're like that anymore.
Those inbox again?
Yeah.
Send connect to network.
Yeah, they're not sending broadband signal.
I just
said
I can't get that.
Mm-hmm. So we're just recalling them and telling them each other, that's all.
Alright,
I believe it's just considering that broadband signal, so you can't get it. I was just unsure if you could do that here, because of the area. So
right.
If you can, they'll allow you to do it.
Alright, so I guess that's another question I had too,
is
like,
go for it.
So these are all things we have over in Portland, Oregon, which we're going to purchase new. But do you guys also do installation or just tech?
I actually don't
see these.
I did that part
of
my life as well.
Like all installation stuff? Yeah,
okay.
One of the big ones we had was we
had to
the digital antenna.
Okay.
Last one we had was installed on
an attic.
I don't know how
you
able to do that, because I know
they
just had to do some drilling because they had to get the line coming out down to the living room to connect.
Wait, well, these are the only channels where certain channels that you were trying to connect to get to,
because
the only ones that I can think of that you
would
get around here is just the local channels. Okay, we like local news. Okay, and you can also get that from the internet as well. Like they give you a lot of local channels on YouTube, so that you don't have to do, yeah, so if you don't have to do that, like you can turn on to YouTube and then it goes to like local 9 or Fox or whatever station that's in this area, and you're able to see it within the area. So you don't have to do all the local channels. Okay. And also on the other half of it, this is why I would recommend it. The feed that you're going to get for it is going to be terrible. So are you familiar with the pixelations that go into TV shows? Or
yeah.
Yeah, so when you're doing digital, you're getting just that digital. And digital comes up really pixelated, very bad. Sometimes choppy, sometimes dry. So if you want the best of what you're going to put in the TV or whatever you're going to use for, I would suggest streaming it to YouTube.
So that's like pretty much fast food. Okay.
Yeah,
and really, the only thing that we watch locally is the local news and Jeopardy. That's it. And Jeopardy, it gets so messed up. It'll stop, and then it'll get all pixelated.
And I don't want to have to go through that, because it's a headache, and I do. But that's the only reason why. And the only other time why I recommend that is because I used to work in Best Buy, but I had clients that used to live in the Boone area, so they're in mountains. And when they were actually digital antennas, I would tell them the same thing, but it's going to be kind of janky up there.
Yeah.
You know, because you're in the mountains area, so you're trying to get
reception
out here. It's going to say it can go 50 miles, but it's not back in the terrain.
Right,
yeah, it's not back in the terrain. So.
Alright, do you want to just...
Now. We'll come back to it if you are satisfied.
Yes. Okay, so you want to see, before all we have is a soundbar.
Okay.
So we're going to put a soundbar for it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we're thinking about now actually getting just small speakers, maybe call it a soundbar or whatever.
Home system, home?
Yeah, so like having, you know, speakers open somewhere, you know,
stand-up
ones or
up
on the ceiling or something.
So you got two options. So there's a good way that you can do it, and there's a best way that you can do it. I don't want to eliminate either option.
Right.
The good way is that Sony, Samsung, and LG all have premium soundbars and also a multi-kit. Meaning that once you get their soundbar, there's additional speakers that you can buy to go with it as well, and they connect seamlessly to it.
Okay.
They're all Bluetooth.
Okay, wireless?
Yeah, they're wireless, so that you have to be all over internet. But it pairs with the Alexa and Google Home System.
Okay.
So it's the soundbar plus the five speakers you can get, so it's a 5.1 channel speaker. Meaning that it gives you five separate speakers and one subwoofer channel.
Okay.
So those are just, I'll show you that, because it's going to happen best buy as well. But. And the other ones too, is the better way, if you guys want a better way. Are you familiar with Sonos?
What
else? Sonos. Okay, so Sonos is a premier sound system quality that people have in their homes,
right.
But it's a lot easier to integrate because it has smart features built on top of the home features that it's designed with. So you have, I think, Play 1, Play 3, Play 5, and then they have a couple of different channels in between. But the Play 1 is essentially like a mini space bar that sits right there that amplifies the sound. The Play 1, are movable speakers that you can take from either in the living room to the bathroom and change them anywhere within the household, and it's still going to be able to function with or without the TV. So they pair with or without Alexa, but they're integratable to go anywhere in the home. So, say for instance, you want to watch a movie out here, soundbar is up there, and one of the mini speakers is out here, he wants to go take a shower in the back. He can take that speaker, go to take a shower in the back, it does not interfere with your system at all. Change it so that now he's able to watch and listen to anything he wants to, while he takes a shower, bring it back, and pair it right back to your TV without ever having. So that's called a Sonos system.
Okay.
Sonos. But it's really good. The other ones I'll show you shortly, but
okay.
I want to get those
letters.
Spots and drops in any of your service.
Okay.
So.
Is the old man that company yet?
play. Oh, wait, say that first one again.
GTA.
GTA? Oh my god. Oh my god. Like,
I Jesus.
Well, I play more kid-friendly games like Mario Kart, Super Smash Brothers, Mario Party.
I play
ARMS. No?
I play Fortnite. No.
Hey, I guess I'm playing, huh? Like,
I play Fortnite.
You play Fortnite? You good at it?
Sorry, okay.
What do you play it on?
Like I'm playing on
Xbox. You're not gonna play it on the Xbox? Wait, hold on. How old are you? 8?
No, she's 11.
8? Yeah.
She's 11.
Oh, okay.
I'm 10.
You're 10? Oh, wow. Okay, I thought you guys were younger than that.
No.
Yeah, when you said PlayStation.
You look 8. What did you say?
Oh, okay.
Oh, it was like.
When you on that?
No, I was speaking with
you. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sound funny. No, I know what them hoes said. Boy, stupid written on my forehead. Think I don't hear what them songs saying. I had run a gang, got a song playing. Try to talk to her, but instead of listening to me, she hear what them bras saying. So we fight, like we fuss. We fuck, we stuck, stuck. She need love, love. Don't trust, don't trust. Pretty soon we back on the same old shit like Robert Robbie.
Y'all see that? Come on, give me a date.
When I first started, it took me two videos, it took me about an hour.
We have it.
That's when I first started. Like, I was slow.
What's happening, my good people? Chill. It is your boy, PK.
I know exactly how much time I got.
Back with another video on How I Did. You
follow the Dough Days of Love.
What's happening, my good people? It is your boy, PKG the Loves. Back with another video on How I Did. You already know what it is. And today I'm here to talk about the opportunities that present itself in front of you and what you could do with them today. All right, so there was about a period when COVID kicked off. Everybody remembers that. Everyone lost their jobs. Everyone got sick. They didn't know what to do. Some people passed away. Sorry about all that. But in that ideal moment of a pandemic, there was also a moment of opportunity. And that opportunity that presented itself left people without a job and left people with thinking of different ways to make more money. Here was one of those ways that I found out immediately after losing my retail job that I had for about 3 years. So each and every one of these skills right here was something that I learned out of a retail network that working there would have probably made me about $100,000 if I was doing it independently. Wait, $100,000? Yes, because it's a slew of information that you have to know. And being in that retail, you're trapped into that hourly circle rage on where you're only getting paid $13 or $15 an hour, whatever it may be. But learning these skills and having this tools to your assessment may just give you the extra bag that you was looking for. So let's get into it for a minute. Let's talk about it for a moment. Each and every one of these skills that I have up has always been something that I've used and had to learn along the way. Starting with the smart home. Any and everything that you get out of a store now, most likely it'll be a technology advanced device that you'll be using, and most people have to figure out how to use that device. It's either you figure it out or you pay somebody to come out there and do it. One of those two options. And when you're losing one of those two, it's also going into your time. Do you really want to take the time to figure out how to do something? Are you really going to be that patient on figuring out something if it were to go wrong? So with these tools that we have here, these are also the opportunities that we use just to make some extra income. So because I know a lot about smart home, because I've seen and touched a lot of things that dealt with the smart locks, I'm able to do smart security SAMs, smart lock systems, smart hub and speaker setups. I'm able to do the smart device setups. What are all those? So if I go into your house and you have an Amazon Alexa or you have a Google Home just sitting on your stand and you're asking me to make that your alarm clock and also configure it into your doorbell so when your doorbell rings, that gets a ring too. All of those things incorporate with each other but require Wi-Fi and a little bit of additional skill that someone has to have if it isn't you. So because of knowing this information piece on how to install and how to set up this stuff, you can make up an extra bag on just doing it. So I've had to learn all these things. Just started with the smart home, one element in itself. But there were more that I went down to because I was one of those people that was considered a jack of all trades. I don't want to say I wasn't a master of none because I mastered them all. So I moved on to doing home theater. Everyone has a TV. If you don't have a TV that isn't a flat back TV, I don't know what type of TV you're using anymore, and you probably should throw it away. So with that being said, TVs that you have are going to be bigger and they're also going to be wider, but they aren't going to have great sound. So then when we start talking about the hookups, the things that go to it, you have your surround sound, you have your sound bar, you have your optical cores. What are these devices? Things that have to go to the TV so that you hear everything from the TV and you get that Dolby Atmos feel when you're in that movie theater or you're trying to get that surround sound feel where the vibrations from the floor make you feel as though, hey, this is an epic movie. This is about to be a great scene. You get those explicits that you don't want to use during the movie, but you're loving because you're engaged with it differently. So learning these skills on how to set up a sound system and give you that full around feel is something that pays you out in the long run. So we started talking about how to make 100K. Just doing these two alone, these two is 100K. No more. You don't have to learn anything else, but just learning those two. Because people will always need help with these two things. How to set up smart devices. What do I need to do? I forgot my Wi-Fi password. I don't know exactly what I'm doing with this. It said it was a simple, easy 1-2-3-step process, and it's not. Hey, that's why you get a technician out here to do it. So learning these skills will get you some bread in your pocket. Moving on to the next one. So let's check this out for a moment. You got computer repair, and you got home office setup. What are those? Computer repair. So, computer tune-up, data backup, new computer setup, virus removal. We all know about those things and what they may entitle, right? So if you don't have an antivirus software system or you didn't have a firewall before you got onto a computer, you caught a hold of the Trojan horses on it, hey, someone's going to have to wipe, restart, refresh your computer. That person would be me. That person is the guy that's going to get it clean. The pilot is going to restart it, reinstall all your software, make sure you don't have all that good stuff anymore, and be able to use your function as if you purchased it for the first time again. So learning these skills aren't hard. Promise you, you probably see a couple of YouTube videos from me or someone else. I'll preferably say myself because I've done videos on these to show you how to set these things up. Because virus removal and cleanup, uninstalling softwares like Word, PowerPoint, Excel, Access and Outlook, all of those applications that you get from Word also go into your software install and software uninstall process that you're going to do. Most people don't know how to do this, don't know where to look for, don't know where to go to, and this is all the money that they have to spend to get this thing figured out. It gets worse. It gets a whole lot worse because now we go into, hey, because I'm on this computer and this is a new computer for me, how do I set up my email? How do I get to my account information? What do I do to look up this? So now you're having to explain and go down the secret steps on what it takes to set up all this stuff because it's going to be complicated for somebody. Just make sure that somebody isn't you. And in the process of doing that, you have a lot of things that you're going to have to put together. So say, for instance, I have a computer over here. I have a printer over here. That person wants me to have this computer talk to this printer so that it prints wirelessly. I have to do that job separately, but it also comes with its own service charge. I know that it's going to require the Wi-Fi to set that up. I know it's going to also require a password. It's going to also require the connection distance that I have or bandwidth that I'll be able to do within. So all of these parameters and things I'm thinking of before I even go to the printer to set it up. But all of this is under computer repair. So anything I touch with a computer at any given point in time, I'm lethal on. And I'm going to tear up and destroy because I'm built that way. So any of these lessons that I'm going to teach, any of these problems I'm going to fix, any of these things I'm going to do, just understand it pays you to do it. So, yeah, this is a good bit of knowledge to learn. Now, we go right into home office and school. Now, we know why this is brought into here, right? But I'm going to go ahead and explain it anyway because I feel like we need to talk about it. All right, home office and school. Most kids since the pandemic have had to go home and learn school from home. So, who else would be better to come out there and set them up for success other than yourself? The person that's going to come out there and make sure the internet works. The person that's going to come out there and make sure all the programs work. The person that's going to come out there and ensure that they're able to log into all their applications and get right into what they need to get into to learn. You could be that person because it's easy. It's an easy buck because you know all of this. And you know the simplest part is you having to set this up for somebody else that needs it. So just understand that diameter of thinking for a moment and see the value in just these two steps alone. So now that we've gone over smart home, home theater setup and hookup, computer setup or computer repair and help, and home office, we got two more things left. One is going to be easier than the other, but I want to make sure I talk about the first one, the harder one first. TV mounting. I don't personally think that TV mounting is hard. I don't think it's difficult. I don't think it's a strenuous process. I think personally most people are afraid. If I see a TV on a wall, I think I can take it down and I think I can put it up. That's just to be honest with you. Most people don't feel that same way. And because most people don't feel that way, that means there's an avenue for revenue right there. Right at that spot, right at that moment. And you have to understand what you're approaching and how you're going to attack that. So any person that does not want to mount a TV or has a fear, you tell them that you can do it and there's going to be a service that comes with it. So any person that has that dilemma that's trying to mount a TV, depending on if it's 1, 2, 3, if it's a 55 or 65 or a multitude of 65, the price value of those TVs go up because someone wants that service done. You go out there being the specialist that you are, knowing the skills that you know, having the tools that you have and the resources that you gain from this experience of talking with me today, you'll definitely be out there able to mount a TV, put it on the wall, and ensure that it's not going to fall at any given point in time because you're built that way. And by the end of this conversation today, we want to ensure that you're built that way. So as we look into these TVs, I just wanted to talk about it because there's a lot of money to be made in that avenue as well. Out of all four of these, you could probably make $100,000 just from this alone. So out of combination of all these jobs, I'm listing all the opportunities that present itself. What you can, what you're able, how far you're able, your capabilities, and I don't want to limit you on anything that you're doing. But I do want to let you know all of the steps is possible and profitable as you're learning. The last one is going to be mobile tablets and setups. There are few and small occasions where you're running to teach someone how to set up a phone. But in those moments that you do, that is also profit as well. So someone that does not know how to get into their Gmail address or don't know how to use these applications, whatever the sort may be, you go in there, you give them that advice, you give them that support, you're able to make a payout because you know the knowledge. All of this stuff that I'm talking about today does not require a lot of hands-on. But as you're knowing the knowledge, you'll realize that each and everything requires you to think about it more than it requires you to do more pushing, do more turning. You have to really apply yourself in thought and how I'm going to do this. So once you understand this, the money will start flowing for you a whole lot faster and a whole lot quicker. So I gave you all this today to let you know the opportunities that are out there that presents itself. You guys can do it because I've seen someone out here that is doing it. I'm on track to possibly do it at this moment. And I want to make sure that everybody around me is on that same playing field, that same stage, because we can all stand up there together. This is $100,000 in action. I'm showing you. You can do this. All of this stuff is not even Googleable, but you can look at it and see, what can I figure out? How can I do it? There are tutorial videos on what you can do to learn more. I just don't want to limit you to say, hey, I worked at a retail store. I worked at a retail store for forever. What other opportunities can I do other than work at this retail store? I was in that same boat. I was in that same boat for about 3 years and I had to figure something out. This is what I figured out. Where to take my skills, and my skills took me to the next level. You got to go to the next level. You can't stay stagnant. You can't stay there. You have to go to the next level. All right? So today, this is just to give you a presentation of everything that you could do to make $100,000 if you learn these skills. Each and every one of them have their own payout, but I promise you, they're gonna be great when you start, all right? PKG Deluxe is in. PKG Deluxe is out, baby. Oh no.